Hello, I'm Will Avakis, and welcome to my humble home. And this is Christmas with Movie Night. Why, who's that behind me? Why, that's Jonathan Rodriguez. And,
Tyler.
The intern.
At least Howard Stern remembered my name.
Okay. And who's that over here? Why, that's our lead producer, Caitlin Manning.
Actually, Will, it's called the Movie Night Holiday Extravaganza.
You're darn tootin' it is. And this is going to be the greatest Movie Night Holiday Extravaganza ever. And I don't think you need any more of these.
Merry Christmas. Enjoy the candy cane.
Hey. Hello there. Welcome, welcome. I'm Will Avakis, and this is the Holiday Extravaganza Movie Night. I believe Albie is here with us as well.
Ho, 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 everyone.
Lord. It's like the ghost of Christmas past.
And you are just like Scrooge.
Okay.
Greedy, selfish, and mean.
Point taken.
Or like the Grinch.
All right. All right. Anyway, guys, let's get on to the episode. Here are your headlines.
This week's headlines are brought to you by Mills Murrow Music.
I have a pen near me. So a lot of things have changed. A lot of things have happened since we've last met. There's been a lot of news in the news. But first off, we have a very special movie review of the Angry Birds 2 movie from our very own Jonathan Rodriguez, and I would just hate to rob him of this limelight. So, Jonathan, tell us what you thought of the Angry Birds 2. Really? Like, that's the only movie?
Well, I just came out of seeing Angry Birds 2, and I have to admit, I liked the first one better. The birds were angrier.
That was something. I mean, why call it Angry Birds if the birds weren't even angry? Why not just call it Birds? But then again, it would be confused with that awesome movie directed by none other than the Alfred Hitchcock. Wouldn't it be something if they made like an animated The Birds?
They didn't do that already?
No, they haven't done it already.
Mario
Lopez, an actor from the 90s, is making a comeback this year. He's been in the Saved by the Bell revival show, which I haven't seen. You know who else is in that? Troy Froman. You know who Troy Froman is? His picture is right here. Right. We're going to key it in later.
Okay.
He's great, though. He's great. He's funny. He was in Saved by the Bell. He played Ox. Are you serious? He was like one of the best parts. You know, I personally enjoyed Saved by the Bell, and I actually like Mario Lopez, for what it's worth. I mean,
you like him whenever you go to the hotel, he does the entertainment menu in the hotel.
That's Dean Cain.
Mario Lopez?
I thought he did, like, Entertainment Tonight.
I think he does, but I think he does hotel ones, too.
Regardless, a lot of actors take jobs for the money, you know, especially these strange projects. Either do it for the money, or maybe it's something that they always wanted to do, but, you know, it's a low-budget independent movie, so they can't really, you know, get the money they want from it, but they want to do it. And then there's this. Which, quite frankly, I don't know what the hell this is. And it's been out for more than a week. I mean, are we serious? Presented by KFC. What the H? I mean, I, much like everyone else who saw this on the internet, I thought it was a joke. Apparently, I don't know if you know this, it wasn't. This was a 15-minute Lifetime original short film that premiered on December 13th. Now, when I think of Lifetime, I most certainly don't think about KFC partnering. I don't even think I've ever seen a KFC commercial on Lifetime. Taco Bell, different story. Maybe if we got lucky. Now, what is this going to be? Are we going to see a rash of these? I mean, The Founder was a great movie, in my opinion. I enjoyed Michael Keaton's performance. It was a little bit bigger budget than this and a longer runtime. Are we going to get the Dave Thomas story? Are they going to throw a Wendy's movie in here? We should beat them to it. Josh Lynch as Dave Thomas. I don't think we could say his name. The lawyers don't sue us. But I don't see KFC partnering with Lifetime to make a movie. It just seems like, what the H? But you know what? After seeing the poster, boy, I'm glad they did. I mean, the idea is so asinine. It's just, it's ridiculous that, damn it, it just might work. And to be honest, in some photos, Mario Lopez could probably pull off a decent Colonel Sanders. Or Boss Hogg, depending on what way you're looking at, you know? He kind of does look like Boss Hogg, doesn't he? Maybe if he gained some weight. He's kind of like, you never see those calendars with the half-naked dudes, and they're like, like, that's the Boss Hogg. I've never seen him. Mm-hmm. I've only heard lore about them.
Yeah, heard tell.
Yeah. I mean, the whole thing just seems like a bucket of trouble. A recipe for seduction, which, yes, that is the title to the movie. I mean, well, I'm not making this up either. A lot of people are like, that's a Photoshop fig. No, sir or ma'am, whatever you are, I'm not judging. I'm not trying to hit your gender, whatever it is.
That's what I thought it was when you sent it to me.
So what's the movie about? Apparently, from what I've read, I haven't seen this movie. Maybe we will need to do a live screening of it. This movie is about a young Harris. Am I Harris? Yeah. Not Harris, like H-A-R-R-I-S. That'd be pretty lame. But a young woman struggles between a wealthy suitor that her mother wants to set her up with and the finger-licking good new house chef, Harlan Sanders. And I'm sure she wants to try more than his 11 herbs and spices.
I'm sure there's more than finger licking going on.
Oh, I'm sure there's a lot more than finger licking going on.
Now.
You know, it's funny because, like, this movie does not even sound like Harlan Colonel Sanders. Like, was he hard up? Was this during a time where he was, like, trying to get money for KFC to start his own restaurant? I mean, most people who are trying to do that just go to gas stations and do some very seedy things at 12:30 at night. Trust me, how do you think I paid for all this? I don't remember. I also don't remember KFC delivering. As bizarre as it must be, that joke did not hit. As bizarre as it must be, there has to be something entertaining or redeeming about this film. So if you've seen it, please send us a 2-minute movie review. Just film it on your phone, send it to us. I would love to know what you think. And I'd also like to know what the fuck this movie is about. You can send your video or YouTube link to movienighttalkshow@gmail.com. I would love to hear what you guys have to say about this.
Hey, this is Bruce Martin from Tonight with Bruce Martin, wishing you a Merry Christmas.
Hello, my name's Jimmy O from the Jimmy O Show in Wigan, England. Just wishing all Movie Night viewers, subscribers a very happy Christmas and New Year.
Thank you, Jimmy O'Neill and Bruce Martin. That's Jimmy O'Neill, Bruce Martin of Tonight with Bruce Martin and the Jimmy O Show with Jimmy O'Neill. check them out, like them on YouTube, like them on Facebook, click that little bell thing that everybody tells you on YouTube to like, smash that like button, and subscribe to them. They could use it, especially during the holiday season. And speaking of holiday seasons, we're back, and with us, spreading the Christmas cheer, is our star lead reporter, Joe Parumpa-pum-pum. And here he comes.
That's not even remotely my name.
Matter of opinion?
Nope, not even close. You like kinda got the first name right, so I'll give you that.
Speaking of which, Joe. Parumpa-pum-pum. Sorry. How you doing out there, buddy? Wait, where are you?
Well, as you can see, I'm reporting live from outside your house.
You're outside my house? Seriously? Joe, buddy. Looks a little cold out there. You wanna come in here?
Well, I'd love to come inside and enjoy the heat, but unfortunately, my invite seems to have been lost in the mail.
Don't worry about that. Come on inside. We got you a little gift, Joe. Come on in.
Is it coal?
On second thought, never mind, Joe. You're not welcome.
Well, you know what? Tis the season to be jolly and not a complete freaking douchebag. So here's what you could do, Will. You could take that coal and you could shove it up your ass. And then you could read my resignation letter. I didn't write it yet, but it's in my head and it's really good. It's gonna burn you so badly. And honestly, I wish I had it in my hand right now.
Hey, you know
honestly,
F you,
I could use the warmth.
Why don't you have a merry kiss my ass and a crappy New Year, Joe? I'm sick of your shit.
I don't know why
all you do is bitch and complain and whine. I taught you the ropes. You know better.
And also, don't forget to go straight to...
Get him off the screen. I don't need any of this. Doesn't matter, folks. I apologize about that outburst. We actually have a brand new reporter in Whoville right now. Trey Clayton, how are things looking for you in Whoville?
I'm here at Whoville right now, and as you can see, the Grinch has stolen Christmas. It's madness all over.
Can you tell us what exactly is going on?
The perpetrator known as the Grinch has snuck into everyone's house, and it seems he's dressed as Santa, and it seems that he's trying to actually ruin Christmas for the Whos. I don't know why, and I don't know how. A better way to do that would be to damage the water heaters or release a raptor into the environment, because the Whos are right now singing and they are still enjoying the holiday spirit.
Uh-huh.
Ho 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 and happy holidays! Back to you, Will.
All right. We'll be right back after this word from Ellie Mueller of Weeknight Update. Subscribe to him as well.
Hi, I'm Ellie Mueller from Weeknight Update. I want to wish everybody out there a very happy holiday season. Now, if only we can get 2021 to start off on a jumpy beat instead of sad and depressing. Years should never be depressing. Thanks.
I'm Mike Doyle from the Movie Raid, and I am wishing you a Merry Christmas. And remember, count off those blessings and those receipts. Happy Holiday!
Welcome back! Thank you. That was an interesting break. Hey, you rock too. Who was that? Why don't you come up here for a second? What's your name?
You don't remember my name still?
Oh, you work for us. Get back behind the camera.
Yes, I'm going back to Stern.
I was trying to pull a Joker thing. Come back here, we love you. Welcome back from the break. If you went to take a leak, you didn't miss much. There's something I want to talk to you guys about, something that gets under my skin every year, something I need to get off my chest. Every year, when Christmas is upon us, the stores unleash something cold, something moist, something odd. Did you get,
It's getting a little hot over here.
Getting a little hot over there? Because I'm freezing in style. Hey! Something odd, because it most certainly is from the depths of hell. And no, I'm not talking about that William Hung Christmas album that came out a couple years back. I'm talking about Fruitcake. And not our intern back there. And not just any fruitcake. I'm talking about this fruitcake. Does it even have a name? You just walk into the store and it's there. I mean, it does have a name, but for all intents and purposes, we're gonna rip the name off of here. If you can even get it open. Oh, son of a bitch, you rip off the box and they have another box inside of it. This is ridiculous. Look at this. Yeah, they have it all wrapped up like, who, why? I don't understand this. First off, how dare you call it a cake? I don't see a cake when I look at this. You know what this looks like? Somebody's Yule log. Like somebody defecated after eating one of these things. Somebody, and that's a lie because nobody ever eats fruitcake. Who eats one of these? Nobody. This isn't a cake, folks. This is a brick of shit. The reason I don't know, I honestly don't know why anybody buys this. And for some reason, the stores still sell it. It's almost like, well, shit, we have a box of those things from 20 years ago. We better put them out on the shelf. You know? Does anybody know the ingredients for fruitcake? I mean, I think I do. It's like fruit
and cake.
Cake and God knows what. You know, it's just, I mean, I'm just kidding. It's fruit, cake, nuts, and apparently disappointment. But it does look like some asshole who just threw a bunch of gummy bears into it, which is usually okay by me, but not this time. I mean, do these things ever rot? I mean, it does look like it's kind of rotting. But it's almost like the baker, when he conceived this, it's like some asshole came in the night of Christmas Eve and was like, I need a cake for Christmas. And he was just like, oh, shit, I gotta throw all this stuff. Like, everything that was left over on the damn table from the day before, he just threw into the damn cake. I mean, that's what it seems like. It's just like, ah, shit, it's just left over. It's meatloaf and whatever. I mean, there is only one thing I hate more than fruitcake. And that's circus peanuts. And that's no secret, all right? I mean, if I wanted to eat something that looked like it contracted syphilis, I'd suck my own dick. Adam over there looks like he's a little sad. Did I go too far?
I'm thinking about it.
I'm sorry. I went a little too far. I'd rather eat a cake that after I took a bite, I didn't feel like I contracted herpes from it. I'd rather eat a cake. Look, I'm getting mad now. I'm getting fired up about this because, first off, somebody's making money off of this thing. I want to eat something that looks fresh, not something that looks like it's been growing in a fucking petri dish. I want to eat a cake that doesn't look like one of the seven wonders of the world. This looks like an archaeologist dug this up and said, hey, it's still good. If I ever got a fruitcake for Christmas, I'd rather use it as a doorstop. I'd rather put it in... I'd rather put it in the dash of my car to ward off any thieves or evil spirits in my area. I don't know if I should eat this thing or put it out of its fucking misery.
Put it in your mouth.
If you ever get this thing as a gift, you know whoever got it for you was a last minute thought. They got this 11:30 p.m. Christmas Eve at a 7-Eleven in a drunken stupor out of desperation to find you a gift, and you know it. Don't act like you didn't know that.
Sir, may I ask you a question?
No, I'm still ranting.
I gave you that gift.
And that's why you're fired.
Oh.
Listen, I'm sure fruitcake can be good. I mean, if you have nothing else in the house. I'm just kidding. Some people like fruitcake, and that's okay. Just know that you have bad taste. Seriously, of all seriousness, there is fruitcake, and then there's whatever the f*** this is. This is not fruitcake. There are some people who have outstanding recipes, great cakes, and they taste good. I've never had any of it. And if you like it, good for you. It's just not for me. I'll stick to what I like. Just don't get me a fruitcake. You know, these are the type of things that you send your worst enemy. But not even I would do that. So if you would like, send fruitcakes in a care package to the address below. It should go to the Bruce Martin Show or the Jimmy O'Neill Show. Don't worry, the Postal Service won't damage them. They've never damaged a fruitcake or lost one yet.
They're indestructible.
They're just about. Look, let me check this thing out. It's just like, you know. As the king of late night, Johnny Carson, once said, this is the world's worst gift. It's the fruitcake. And there's only one fruitcake in the entire world, and people keep giving it to each other. So, I've never had fruitcake, so I'm going to try it right now.
Eat it.
I'd rather you say eat it than put it in your mouth.
Put it in your mouth.
What have I...
Hope you like it, boss.
Oh, you were right. We should have refrigerated this.
That's going to be disgusting.
All right, we're going to open this and get it out of the package. And...
it's a third package.
Mmm, Great Depression flavor.
Mmm, that's what Josh said, Great Depression flavor. Oh, look at that.
Oh, I think
so,
cat litter in there.
After...
after...
What did you say, ants on a turd?
Yes.
After I eat this thing that looks like somebody's that fell off during the war. If I die, we're not renewing the show. Here we go. We're going to try this fruitcake.
Wow, boss.
Swallow.
Chew it.
Oh, my God.
Get it down your gullet.
I'm chewing it up.
Well,
good thing you're
a beverage. Finish the bite. Finish it.
I think you bit off.
Spit it out.
Oh.
Whirl it. You can't hold that against me.
Yes, we can.
I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why you can't hold that against me. Because fruitcake is nastier than hell. It tastes like somebody... What was in that? Potpourri?
Yes.
Oh my God. Who eats this? Why would you eat this?
It's about to fall off the thing.
Exactly. Why would you put yourself through this torment? I mean, excuse me.
Oh, I think it's how FDR got polio.
As Josh Lynch just said, in case you didn't hear him, would you say this was made the year that FDR got polio?
It's how FDR got polio.
You know, FDR made this for his wife one Christmas. And he left her a letter that said, my dearest wife, I made you one of the greatest gifts of all this Christmas season. For if I'm lying, please make me president during the greatest depression of all and give me polio. That's it. Cut the commercial. This is gross.
What does it taste like?
It tastes like, you want to know what it tastes like?
What?
Not like f***ing profits. Like this, this thing tastes like disappointment. It tastes like, you ever been to an orphanage before?
No.
That's what it tastes like. This tastes like every old lady's house when you walk in. This tastes like this has been in a house with a bunch of cats.
Oh, God.
Well, let me see the other edge. I want to take a bite of this.
No. Come around here then.
It tastes like Industrial Revolution London.
It tastes like Industrial Revolution London, you're right.
I can eat milk steak. I can eat this.
You're not going to eat this.
Why?
Here, bend down with me.
Why did I eat milk steak then?
Here, you eat it.
He ate that milk steak.
Let's dissect this.
It's not bad.
What do you mean it's not bad? It's the most disgusting thing I've ever had.
One, I gave this to you for your Christmas gift. It's delicious.
You're not even in frame.
This time, let's roll.
For realsy this time. We'll be right back. I could use some applause.
Oh.
We'll be right back. Thank you very much. Welcome back. Thank you guys for tuning in. That's all we got for you tonight. That's all she wrote, folks. I'm glad to be back in this chair. It's been a lot of fun. There's going to be a lot of changes coming up in 2021, both for the show and for me. One of the reasons why I wasn't on the show is because I was doing these live event shows at Fox Gold Coast Theater in Ocean City, Maryland, where I general manage the theater. And what we were doing was showing an old horror film, and then I would do a Joe Bob Briggs ripoff and commentate about the film and do a little dog and pony show, and then afterwards we would stay and talk about the movie. And it took up a lot of my time, but it was really very fun. And You know, there was a great community of people that I've met, and I just want to say thank you to those people, whether they watch the show or not. One of them being Joe DeGristine, Doug Spencer, Fred Haas. If I'm pronouncing your name wrong, Fred, sorry. I think Dylan Warwick, Michael McIntyre, Josh Taylor, a great filmmaker. A lot of people who tuned in to come to this horror thing, and we kind of just became a community. And I just want to say I really appreciate you folks out there. So thank you guys for tuning in. And thank you, the audience at home, for tuning into this show. You know, it's been a wild year, COVID, and then this show. And I love doing it. I love doing this show, and I love talking to you guys and making some of you laugh and whatever else you might do when watching this show. I don't ask questions, and I most certainly don't want you to tell me. Right now, there's some dude, like, you know, nah, I'm going to say it. But thank you guys for tuning in. I hope you guys have a happy holiday. Whatever it is you celebrate, let's hopefully end this year with some positivity. Let's not be negative, guys. Let's make the best of whatever we have going on here and move into 2021. It's almost like a museum. Don't touch anything. And maybe, just maybe, everything will be okay. A lot of people have been asking me, Will, are we going to be okay? And I always say the same thing. Fuck if I know. So guys, whatever you do, it's a very depressing time. Now, whether you're depressed about the election results, COVID-19, your job situation, here's what my advice for you. Never stop creating. This was a dream of mine. This is something I started on my own with some friends' help. If it wasn't for my friends and some of the coworkers I work with at the theater, this would have never have happened. I was very depressed. When I started doing this show, it was like a weight lifted off my shoulders. So whether you have stress with your job, maybe you're unemployed, maybe your boss is giving it to you without lube, happens all the time. I'm used to it. Maybe you're going through a divorce. Maybe you've been cheated on. Whatever it is that might be. Maybe you're having financial issues. Keep making the art. Keep doing what you like to do. And do it the way you want to do it. Don't listen to anybody else. Do it your way. Because that's the only way. Be happy and have fun with it. And that's the only advice I have for you guys. Go into the new year. That's your new year resolution. Make a project that you've always wanted to make. And don't listen to the haters. You're going to have, for each person that supports you, you're going to have a hater. And they won't make it known either. They're going to hide in the bushes. And most of the time, your haters are the people you trust most. The people you don't suspect to be the hater is the hater. Don't worry about them. That's not their battle. This is your battle. So go out there, be creative, make me proud. And I know you don't know me. You don't know me from Adam. But whatever you create, I want to see it. And you know what? I will judge you on it. Not harshly, but I want you to get better. Trust me, it's the internet. You think that we get around without people calling us idiots, you know? Your show sucks. I will give you constructive criticism on your project. I would love to do that. I'd love to help you out. Send me your projects. Let me see what you're doing. Let me review them. Let me look at what you're doing. Maybe you're trying to create a new light. Maybe you're trying to create a new movie. Maybe it's a book. Maybe it's a script. Maybe it's just an audition video. I would love to check out what you can with the time I have. Be creative. Do what you want to do. Unless it's killing a bunch of people. Don't do that. Be nice to one another. Be kind. Share the wealth. Now, I know I'm talking to a blank wall because nobody watches this show. But I felt like I say this all the time. And maybe it falls on deaf ears, but it doesn't hurt to say it again. Keep being creative. There is no martini shot after this. I'll see you guys in the new year. I'll be freezing in style. So I love you guys. Thank you for supporting me. Keep being creative. Happy holidays. Actually, Norman, I'm going to have to let you go. Appears there's somebody at my door. Yes, on Christmas Eve.
I don't give a shit!
All right.
Prick.
Oh, good Lord. Hello there.
Hi, I'm Adam Clifton. I live down the road.
Oh. Yeah, I'm not grabbing your ass or anything. I'm just closing the door, okay?
That's all right.
Alrighty.
Are you the new John Stewart?
It's been a while since I've been called the new anything. Why don't you come on in? Adam Clifton, you say?
Yes, yes.
Oh, you're the one that sings, right?
I do. Right or wrong.
You know, it's Christmas Eve. Would you mind singing a song with me?
Not at all.
Oh, well, thank you. I like the old music. Are you familiar with the band Slingin' Daisies?
No.
Well, there goes that. For doing all the hard work you've done on this show, I got you a gift.
Well, I'll be darned.
I think you're really going to like it.
Oh, boy.
Why don't you open it up and show all the folks at home what you got?
Ah, what I always wanted. A kazoo.
Orchestra.
Ho-ho! Well, do you know this song?
Maestro, have at it. Oh, oh yes. That's a fine tune. Good choice, Maestro. Come, they told me, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. A newborn king to see, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. Our finest gifts we bring, pa-rum-pa-pum-pum. Rum-pa-pum-pum. Peace on earth, can it be? Years from now, perhaps we'll see. See the day of glory. Pum 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 pum.
Merry Christmas, everyone!